I'm gonna be tied up again. Takes him down. Got him into the small package. Got one, two. Now Gilbert is rolled over. And they're kicking, rolling around. Cannot get but a two count. And that's it. And they're both out of it right now.
Oh, yeah. It's a real nice shot. I'm gonna be.
I'm enjoying the wrestling match. Will you stop all
Who
this
cares
stuff
what you
like
enjoy?
Well,
you want to enjoy something? I'll give you something to enjoy.
Beautiful. Absolutely illegal move. And Rich comes back. They're teeing off on each other now. Rich nailed him in return with a forearm. Both of those moves were illegal. And now Hot Stuff back in the ring. I believe you're right at this point if you said he is a little hot.
I'll tell you what.
Tommy Rich. Come on.
I'll give my business card to the first guy that throws a punch. How's that?
Great.
I've made a lot of money with both of these guys. I'd love to manage either one. And as for Missy, hey, I'll give her a position too. And if Tommy Rich, hey, I'll do something with Davey and Johnny. I tell you what I'll do. I'll take care of their family for the rest of their lives. I'll chuck Johnny and Davey's heads off. I'll put them on a barbecue and feed them to the Samoan squad team.
5 minutes to go right now. And Eddie Gilbert takes that arm and turns it over.
5 minutes. That means 300 seconds. 300 seconds for either one of these two to lose a match. And it only takes 3 seconds to win a match. 3 seconds to win a match. So that leaves 297 seconds for one of these two to lose their temper. And who cares if Missy loses their temper? Get the camera on the ring.
Tommy Wildfire Rich, who is desperate to fight his way back into recognition in the top 10 of the NWA. Up in the air goes Gilbert. He drops him down. Oh, boy. I know what kind of you have felt.
He's
it
hurt
yourself when you've been hit accidentally right there in that lower leg on that bone with no need of protection. Tommy Gilbert comes in behind, leg sweep out, it goes. It's all legal, Paul. They came in here to rush you and see who is the better man. Referee Tommy Young said that the shoulder came up on the count. Boy, he had him down in such a beautiful lock
position.
I thought he had.
3 minutes in the match.
3 minutes to go. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Wildfire Tommy Rich, and what has been an enormous exhibition of great, great wrestling. Look at him power at it. You think they don't want to win here? That shows you the intensity. Good friends and all. Forget it, partner. We have got a wrestling match going to see who is going to improve their standing.
Pick
in
his
the
ball NCAA like Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert.
He's got it. Wildfire Tommy Red saying, no, no, no. He puts his shoulders down and gets them up. It's not a pinhole. It is more of a submission. But sometimes, and I've seen wrestlers get carried away by the pain, and they will forget the shoulders
right
down and get pinned.
That's how Ric Flair won his third World Heavyweight Championship, and that just could be how Ric Flair loses it when Terry Funk gets his hands on him again. But if you want to talk about violence, if you want to talk about brutality, there are 2.5 minutes left in this match. One of these two guys is going to have to lose his temper to beat the other.
Well, that's your prediction of things. They've done a beautiful job of staying within the rules, and yet the intensity you won't find in any cover anywhere in any match.
2 minutes.
2 minutes.
120 seconds left, and that leaves 120 seconds for either Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert or Wildfire Tommy Rich to lose their temper.
Gilbert takes him right over towards the ring post, has the leg outside the rope. The referee. And
there
Gilbert
you go.
Slams it into the ring post.
Oh, yeah.
He's counting it down with 2 minutes to go. And he hurts that leg of Tommy Rich. But Rich comes back and
spares him right from the
This just goes to show that friendship does not mean as much as the NWA Top 10.
Takes him over.
1 minute in the match.
60
one
seconds
minute.
Left.
Down to the 1 minute mark. One, two, and Rich kicks his way out of it. Tommy Wildfire Rich didn't come this far to have it go that easy. Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert again. A nice block as Rich breaks that leg. Great finds that leg and takes him right back over again.
And once again, they're affecting a figure four showing on Wildfire Tommy Rich, but he has about 30 seconds left to break into the NWA Top 10 by taking down
me.
I even know my time, and I'm unbelievable.
30 to go. Rich is moving. Gilbert down underneath. Slam into each other. And down to the mat they go as the time is running out. The referee's starting to count. Will one of them get up here at the end?
Shut up, Missy.
On his feet.
15 seconds.
2 seconds to go. We are going to end up with a brawl.
No, we're not. Like one of these two's going to lose their temper.
Into
sleeper hole.
A big sleeper hole from Rich.
This is what Jet Harley raced up when Tommy Rich beat him for the NWA World title in 1981. And Eddie Gilbert is going down, and it looks like Gilbert's going to go down. It looks like Rich can beat him here into the NWA Top 10.
Rich is keeping all of his weight right on top of Gilbert so that he's bending the head down and cuts the oxygen, cuts the blood right out of the carotid artery. And that is the bell.
Tommy Rich won!
Tommy Rich won!
I knew it! I've been saying it the whole time that Tommy Rich would lose his temper and win. I'm so happy for him. I knew he'd win. I've been saying it since the beginning of the show.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the hand of
Tommy Rich never gave up. The referee has ruled this match a draw.
A draw!
I knew it!
It is not a victory
I
for
told
Rich.
You, neither one of these two are man enough to lose their temper. If I was Eddie Gilbert, I'd slap Misty for keeping him back.
We're going to be right back with Jim Ross and Jim Cornette.
Who cares about Jim Cornette? I have other things to say.
Hush, buddy.
Don't tell me to hush.
Welcome back, fans. We're right here in Amarillo, Texas. Jim Cornette and Jim Ross. And I'll tell you something, that was a great main event, 15-minute draw. It was a great main event in the top contenders list, the 10 top contenders. That's a list that everybody wants to be on, and this is a professional sport. Sometimes you're going to have to wrestle your friends, as we saw there with Eddie Gilbert and Tommy Rich.
I'll tell you another thing. The wrestler of the week this week is a man that is setting atop the top 10, the world champion.
The world heavyweight champion, the guy who proved last week that Space Mountain is open for business. The Nature Boy, Ric Flair, is this week's Wrestler of the Week, and for my vote, the Wrestler of the Decade.
And also, fans, coming up tomorrow night at 6:05 World Championship Wrestling. Corny, we got a great show tomorrow night.
Well, we got the Riches going up against the Freebirds, and myself being involved in the situation with the Freebirds and the Midnight Express, I want to see what kind of luck the Riches have with them. That's going to be a main event match on World Championship Wrestling, and also, we're going to see some interviews concerning last week's big Great American Bash in Baltimore, so I know everybody's going to want to see what everybody had to say, all the excuses of why people lost, and all the celebrations of why people won.
Plus, fans, I want to invite you to join Paul E. Dangerously and I this Sunday night at 6:05 Eastern Time. That'd be nice. Join me.
Join you.
Don't pay attention to Paul E.
The door's open all the time.
That's right. And
keep a lot in the refrigerator.
Maybe I'll even give you a phone number.
You can see where he keeps it.
I'm moving to Atlanta, you know.
The ratings are going up, you
They're
know.
They're going up. We're hot. And we'll be back next week. Check your local listings for the Power Hour next Friday night. We'll see you everybody tomorrow night.